World Series 2017 schedule, Astros vs. Dodgers Game 2 TV info and predictions. Justin Turner propelled the Los Angeles Dodgers to a 1-0 World Series lead Tuesday night thanks to a two-run home run in the sixth inning, but the Houston Astros should have an excellent opportunity to even the score Wednesday evening. Justin Turner comes up clutch. /worldseries.https://t.co/81LeVeJustinVerlander, who is coming off an MVP-caliber performance in the ALCS, will be on the hill for the American League champions, while the Dodgers will counter with Rich Hill in what figures to be another low-scoring affair under the sweltering Los Angeles sun. With the action fast approaching, here's a rundown of when and where you can catch Game 2 of the Fall Classic. If there's one pitcher who can help the Astros steal a game in Hollywood, it's Verlander. The 34-year-old has been electric to this point in the postseason, and his shutdown stylings against the New York Yankees served as a warning shot that should have the Dodgers scared. In two starts against the Bronx Bombers, the 2011 American League MVP rattled off a pair of wins as he scattered 10 hits over 16 innings and struck out 21 batters while walking two. "I think the mental focus is just at another level," Verlander said, according to MLB.com's Anthony Castrovince. "I think it's something that would be easy to say, why don't you just do that every game? It's unsustainable throughout the course of the regular season. If you are that mentally focused, you'd just burn out. It's just another level. I don't know how to really explain it." If there's hope for the Dodgers, it's that Verlander doesn't have a track record of success in the Fall Classic. According to MLB.com, Verlander posted a 7.20 ERA in his three previous World Series starts with the Detroit Tigers. Verlander's last appearance on the game's biggest stage came in 2012, when he surrendered 5 earned runs in 4 innings of an 8-3 Game 1 loss to the San Francisco Giants. According to NBC Sports' Craig Calcaterra, history suggests a repeat of that performance could doom the Astros. In 112 World Series, teams have gone down 0-52 times. Only 11 of them have come back to win. You're up, Justin Verlander. The Dodgers, meanwhile, will turn the ball over to Hill in search of a 2-0 series lead. And unlike Verlander, who has made 4 starts in October, Hill will be taking the mound for the first time in 10 days. The 37-year-old was particularly efficient last time out, when he helped lead the Dodgers to a 4-1 Game 2 win over the Chicago Cubs by recording 8 punchouts in 5 innings while allowing just 3 hits. Now headed back to the bump, Hill will try to baffle an Astros lineup that doesn't have much experience against his fastball and maddening curveball, as Climbing Tall's Hill highlighted. Game 2 preview. #Dodgers Rich Hill vs. current #Astros batters. /worldseries.https://t.co/arcs2. Really, at the end of the day, it's about attacking and staying convicted in your approach, Hill said, according to the Houston Chronicle's Jake Kaplan. "You get to this point and it's not about changing your game plan or doing something different, right? You've done your homework, you've prepared throughout the entire season to get to this point." Hill should have some early success against the Astros, but the bet here is that Houston will start to churn out hits a second time through the order and give Verlander the run support he needs to knot the series at 1 game apiece heading back to Minute Maid Park. Prediction: Astros 5, Dodgers 3.